part of their building is a production PDR, artist space, work area. The other part of their project is an office to assist the artist, as well as a showroom space. That project was approved.
Where was that? Where?
470 to 498 Alabama, in South of Market. I also have a very large project, which is this is notice of public hearing for June 15th, which is adoption of CEQA findings, amendments to the general plan, zoning map amendments, conditional use, variance, shadow, in-kind lieu fee for low market rate housing. This is June 15th, 12 noon, at City Hall, room 400. There's also a hearing on July 6th for 1101 Fillmore Street in the Fillmore Neighborhood Street Commercial District, which would change a beauty supply store to Little Caesars Pizzeria. And I have a public hearing on June 22nd for 768 Harrison, which is a large project authorization, which would build an 83-foot tall, 8-story over basement, mixed-use building with 24 residential units. And they're going after variances for, because they have no vehicle parking and for open space. Also on June 22nd, for 65 Cap, there's a project for a small performance theater with limited commercial use, pursuant to planning code section 209.4, 303, and 710.48, which requires a variance for street frontage for transparency requirements. I also have a public hearing on June 7th for 72 Ellis Street, which is across from the flood building. They want to build a 130 foot tall, 11 story over basement tourist hotel on a parking lot in a historic conservation district, and planning for the Historic Preservation Commission. It did go before the Historic Preservation Commission last week. Sorry about that. And one of our projects was heard last week. On my building applications, I have a building application for 157th Street, which is to convert an office building into a residential building, adding two additional dwelling units with retail. And I have another building permit application for 1950 Mission Street, which would convert a navigation center, which it currently is, into residential housing and institutional social service use of childcare. This is the one why they're moving navigation in South of Market to its new location, which the commander was talking about last time.
So this navigation is where?
Right now, the navigation center is on Mission. It's moving to South Van Ness.
Okay, so it's on Mission 16th in the or something.
I also have a building application for 557th Street, which is currently a PDR and office. They want to add two stories to their building to make more office space, which I think is great. Finally, we're not tearing down a building. I think it's great. I also have, which is having a public hearing on June 22nd, which I have the mitigated bay deck for 77 to 85 Federal Street. It's a large project, an office authorization, and it's a new construction of a 5-story over basement with 49,000 square feet of office use on the upper floors, 25 parking spaces, and ground floor retail. I also have a community evaluation plan initial study for 999 Folsom Street, 310 6th Street, which consists of a rectangular project site, which has a 3-story building currently sitting on it, which would be torn down. And the project It'd be an eight-story, 82-foot tall building with 95,000 square feet, including parking. Will include 34 two-bedrooms, 49 one-bedrooms, and one studio apartment. I also have a community plan evaluation for 1726 to 1730 Mission, which is two parcels, which will be combined into one parcel. The project plans to build an 80-foot tall building with 21 parking spaces and bicycle spaces. And it doesn't say in my evaluation here how many units are in the building. I also have a notification for free application for a medical cannabis dispensary at 763 Bryan Street. That's land use for this one. And they're still working over there. For legislation, on June 19th, from 10 a.m. on, is public hearing on the budget for San Francisco. So if you want to make comment on the budget, June 19th on Monday is the day to do it. It's the only day public comment is accepted by the board. All other information from the board is for agencies only. So if you want to make a comment, do it on June 19th.
Was that dispensary at 763 Bryan? I'm sorry. Can you please repeat that?
761 Bryan.
761 Bryan. Thank you.
On budget and finance committee agenda, item one, this is for the 6th, this is for the 15th, which is Thursday. Item one on the agenda is real property acquisition by the Rec and Park Department for 145, 165 11th Street, 973 Minnan Street, 964 Natoma Street. The Rec and Park is buying this property for $9,725,000. Also on the agenda for interest down here is sponsored by the mayor. There's a neighborhood beautification and graffiti cleanup fund tax designation ceiling for tax year 2017. It's an ordinance. Everything else is budget.
What was that last one again? What was the last one? The last one.
Neighborhood beautification and graffiti cleanup fund tax designated ceiling. What it does is sets the ceiling for tax funds collected for graffiti and beautification. Also on land use committee, which was held yesterday and is in a continuing ongoing process, the exclusionary affordable housing fee and dwelling unit mix requirement sponsored by Bree, Kim, Petskin, Sophia, whatever, and Tang, which would amend the planning code to revise the amount of exclusionary affordable housing fee and on-site, off-site affordable housing alternatives and other exclusionary housing requirements to require minimum dwelling unit mix in all residential districts. That was introduced in December of 2016 and has been substituted three times, amended twice, and they're still working on it. Also here yesterday is item six on their agenda, which is called Owner Move-In Reporting Requirements, sponsored by Farrell, Sheely, Cohen, and Reed. It's an ordinance that would require an amended administrative code require landlords seeking to recover possessions of rental unit based on owner move-in or relative move-in to provide declaration under penalty of perjury stating that the owner intends to occupy the unit as principal place of residence of the landlord or the landlord's relative member for at least 36 continuous months, require landlord seeking to recover possession of rental unit based on OMI or RMI, provide a tenant with a form prepared by the rent board to be used to advise the rent board of any changes in the address. Requires landlord to file annual documentation with the rent board for 3 years after the OMI or RMI showing whether the landlord or relative was occupying or is occupying the unit as their principal place of residence. It requires the landlord to annually notify the unit occupant of a maximum rent for the unit for 3 years after OMI and RMI is concluded. That's also going to be substitution, and we'll put that with motion to be heard at today's board meeting. On public safety, neighborhood services, which is tomorrow's calendar, there is a hearing to update on the city's homeless population and services being provided to the homeless, sponsored by Coleman and Rowan, which was here from the Department of Homelessness and Supportive Housing, Public Works, Department of Public Health, and Police Department on the needs of the homeless. And then also for public safety, which this was on June 5th at 11 o'clock, there was a hearing on something called Fire Victims Assistance Fund, which is an ordinance sponsored by Roman and Weber to amend the administrative code to allow tenants who have been displaced by fires to receive payment for the Fire Victims Assistance Fund for up to 4 years instead of 2 years, if they earn 70% of the area median income or less. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I know what they do.
Can I have a list later?
Yes?
Can you give me a list of this later or something? So many.
Raise your hand so we can speak louder, and you can present because our overhead projector is not working.
I have one.
What, a projector?
Yeah, if you want to try it, if you can't get it to work.
You said it's a problem.
It's up to you, and I don't want to, I want to be respectful of time.
We can go back to something else, if you want to, if you try to get it to work, I mean, great. No, but we can go to something else.
If you can get it going,
yeah. Yeah, I know that you can't, because it will help all the presenters. All right, see, you never know what goes on until it happens. Okay. We're going to then now go, just briefly, we're going to mention the announcements, which is item 13 on the agenda. On June the 14th is the mobilization of Everyday's People Budget on Wednesday the 14th at noon at City Hall. They're going to go around to the various supervisors and ask for, try to get funding the various issues for the People's Budget. Friends of Boudicca Park is going to be on June the 14th at 1:30 at Boudicca Park, which is right next door to this building. The Tenderloin Community Benefit District will be doing a Tenderloin Talk Live on Wednesday the 14th at 5 at 201 Turk Street. It's going to be, they're going to start a new quarterly of presentations talking about their programs and stuff. The Tenderloin Community Benefit District will be having their board meeting on June the 19th at 5 o'clock at their offices at 512 Ellis Street. Southern Station Police Captain's meeting will be on Wednesday the 21st at 6:30 at 95 McCaughan Street. You can meet the captain, which is Captain Daryl Baum. And then another free event. It will be the Pride Celebration on the 24th at Civic Center Plaza. And then the 47th parade will be 10:30 on Sunday the 25th. And the, again, more celebration in the Civic Center Plaza on the 25th, starting at 11. And then the Tenderloin Police Station's Community Room will be on Tuesday the 27th at 6 p.m. at the Tenderloin Police Station's Community Room at 301 Eddy Street. And our next Alliance meeting will be on Tuesday, the July the 11th, which will be in this room. And basically, it'll be another either stakeholder meeting or depending what's on the agenda. Now, we've heard that there's some people have asked the time for any other person that has announcements. Yes. Come on. Right here. And everybody else, after him. Right here.
Over here. As I said earlier, Cadillac Hotel, and we have each month a free concert aimed at people in this Tenderloin community. It goes on for about an hour. It's usually on a Friday. It's not the first or the second or the third. It kind of varies. But these people are all very professional. Sometimes it'll be a 5 or 6 piece band. Sometimes, usually it's jazz. Last month we had Beatles music. This month, Joel Tepper is coming. He has been to the Cadillac before. He's a retired concert pianist. Played with many orchestras here on the West Coast, and he's going to be playing the 24 Chopin preludes. And these concerts are recorded, and they give out like a dozen or two dozen previously recorded CDs to people who attend, and everybody gets a cookie. We got a cookie lady. Anyway, it's a lot of fun. Please come. I got about 18 of these, and I want to give every one of them away.
I'll put one up in my bulletin board in my building.
All right. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, you can pass the rest of them.
Okay.
Thank you again, everybody, for sticking with us and being so patient. Without further ado, we are going to continue from the beginning of the agenda with our first presentation that requires technology. I'm just going to turn the lights down. And can everybody see, or should we check this out too, or?
That's fine.